ToDoIst has done some awesome updates when it comes to their custom views. And in this video, I'm going to break down how to organize your to-do list on ToDoIst in various ways. But if you actually want to learn way more about ToDoIst, I have just released my ToDoIst Mastery course, which you can get on Skillshare and or my Gumroad website. The links to both of those will be in the description as well as in the pinned comment down below. Also, if you sign up for Skillshare using my custom link, you will get 1 month free. Now, diving into ToDoIst, the thing about the new views feature is that on the top right here, there's a few different things that people probably don't get when they're first messing around with ToDoIst. You cannot drag or move tasks in your today's view, or when you're working in labels, or when you're working in filters. But what you can do is move them around when you are in projects. And that is only if there is no custom sorting on. So just to show this for you guys right here, we go to the view section, there is a sorting option where you can sort things alphabetically, by due date, by priority. As you can see here, P1's on the top, P2, P3. And then if I made a task P4 today, this would be on the bottom. And if I tried to move it, I would not be able to because it's sorted. But if I get rid of custom sorting, then I could move them around. And when it comes to the custom views part of things, you can do a fair amount with your today view and with your filters. So I have a today view here, and the way that it works is actually, so in Notion, how it works is if you have a day set and two things are on the same day, the tasks that have no time associated with it will be on the top. However, in ToDoIst, if you have a time associated with it, the task with the time will be associated on the top. Because if you can see here, I will get rid of this at 5 a.m. and notice this is what's on the top. Now, if I get rid of custom sorting, it's still going to be the same case regarding the order of time. In ToDoIst, what I recommend you do is test out what you want to have your productivity system based on. So I use the TTP method. So I order things by time, trees, and priorities. So time comes first, and then trees would be the different projects of my life. So side hustle, work, growth, housekeeping, someday maybe. So if I go group by, then I do a project, then as you can see, I'm grouping it in a way that makes sense for me, where it would be the most important thing on the top, and then it would go cascading down. And then how is it going to be sorted though? That is the question that most people ask. So then what you can do is you can have a default sorting, or you can make it more specific than that. We can have due date, which tweaks it so that it's the time on top that is most early here. Or we could even have it change to priority. So this makes it so that for people who want to have it this way, that the most important tasks regarding priority are on the top. But in the method that I use, I would actually have due date, because time trees priorities, whatever the thing that matters on the higher time matters more. And I think, say you had to go to a doctor's appointment at 10 a.m. I mean, obviously you're going to do that at that time. That would only make sense. And then another thing about sorting in ToDoIst is that there's two different ways that you can change the order of what you have here. So if I press this and go to order, do descending or ascending, it flips it so that it's the opposite of whatever it was by default. So the descending version is having the things that are, in this case, a due date with no time associated with it on top, similar to how Notion is. That if I flip it back, it goes the other way. And then I could also flip that by pressing this in the reverse order section. Now you can do the exact same sort of grouping in the same level of functionality in label views. Unfortunately, you cannot do that in project views because, well, grouping would not make much sense by projects if you are already in a project. But you can still group things by priority, date added, due date, have the normal default one, and then label. And the nice thing about the default view is that you can move sections around. So if I have an extra section here and I, like, let's say I duplicate this section just as an example, can take this and move it back and forth. And then this is sort of an inbox with things that aren't in a specific section. You can take one of these and drag it into one. Then if you want to change between the board and the list view, you can just hold down Shift V and it'll go back and forth between that. Just press that button. So then really quick, I want to go into a filtered view to show an example for you. So if we go into today's work tasks, or actually important tasks, and I right click, edit filter, I can show you it's today and not a priority for us. So this is essentially everything that's today and not unimportant. So going into important tasks, you can actually do the exact same thing that you would in the today view, where it's view. I could group it by default where there's nothing there, or I could group it by priority, label, project. Let's do project. And that would make it in the same system that I have currently, which is time, trees, priority. So I can section it off based off of the different life aspect that I have. And then I can do a custom sort, so I could sort it by priority, or I would want to do it by due date and then have it ascending. So that it's time first. Then after that, we see what other task needs to get done. And then it actually by default will do priority as a last layer defense. If I made these both 5 a.m. and changed one of them to a P2, you'll see immediately that two things that are at the same time will actually get put down as in the order of priorities. And then if I got rid of time for all of these and just only had it at April 15th, the exact same thing would happen where it would just order it by priorities. And then in label views, you can do the exact same thing where you can group it by different things like due date, assignee, date added, priority, label. Not sure why you do label in a label view, but you can also do project, and it's got the same functionality there, but in these views, you cannot shift between a board and a list view, which is okay in my opinion, because it's not really project based and it's more about looking at what tasks you need to immediately, and board views don't really do the same thing in my mind, at least for that. Once again, if you enjoyed this tutorial on ToDoIst, make sure to check out my ToDoIst mastery course in the link down below. I really want to help you guys improve your productivity, so I'm releasing this course first, and then once more things come out with Notion, I'm going to release that. I have a habit building course that's going to be coming out in the next few months, and I'm really excited for that. Make sure to check the course out and check out this video to see how you can improve your productivity even more.